And I wanted to reveal an important sacred secret to all of you from my personal experience. I think even though it is too mystical, I can reveal it. Whoever is my disciples and able to connect with what I am saying, you connect. Others, it's okay. What is there? When I assumed this body, I collected biomemory from Arunagiri Yogeshwara, Meenakshi, little bit from Swami Vivekananda. When I collected the biomemory and made this body and assumed the body, took birth, I saw suddenly I have updated even my Meenakshi biomemory. Understand? Biomemory of Meenakshi continues to grow. You may think, are they not perfect? They are perfect, but not end. Understand? Enlightenment is ultimate, but not final. Meenakshi is ultimate, no doubt, but not final. The ultimate goes on exploding into ultimate. The ultimate exploding into ultimate. It is a constant expansion, constant expansion, constant expansion. Constant expansion of certain flow is what I call abundance. Life is abundance. Existence is abundance. You go on creating. Understand? You are a creator. If you want to spend time on wealth creation, you will do that. If you want to spend time on peace creation, you will do that. If you want to spend time on creating spiritual bliss, you will do that. Constant expansion. We will bring the temple-based lifestyle back to life. I'll just travel from city to city, village to village, country to country, putting my hand, one hand on the hip and the other hand on the golden staff, looking up. Only the temple towers I am building all over the world. We will bring the temple-based Vedic lifestyle back to life. Life is expansion. Life is expansion. We'll go on be expanding, expanding, expanding. Life is abundance. By its very nature, existence goes on expanding. Even scientists are saying the whole cosmos is continuously expanding, expanding, expanding. The very quality of existence is expansion. Be consoled. Life is not for death. Be consoled. Existence is not sadist. There is no negativity. It is a causeless, reasonless expansion. In understanding, in wealth, in life, in bliss, it is expansion, expansion, expansion. This should be the today's thought trend. Continuous expansion. Source, cause, existence is bliss. The today's sutra expresses the source, cause, existence is expansion, abundance. Yesterday's sutra is source is bliss. Yesterday's sutra is said, when you realize source is bliss, bliss attracts fortune. Today's sutra, the essence is source is expansion. Source is not just bliss. Source is bliss and expansion. So today have your debate, vada prativada, in these lines. How source is expansion? How? By being in source or being in existence, you can go on creating. Understand? Every thought which happens in you itself is abundance. Thinking is abundance. Thinking is wealth. I tell you, if you are having poverty by thinking, you want poverty as your wealth. Whether it is poverty or wealth, it is your abundance. Who knows? Maybe, like a Tenali Rama's cat story. Tenali Rama had a cat. Tenali Rama is a Hindu version of Joker, Mulla Nasruddin, Hindu version of Mulla Nasruddin. He's from Tenali, small village from Andhra. He was an intelligent joker. You can't even call him as a joker, an intelligent comedian in Vijayanagara's empire, a great personality. So many stories are attributed to him. By birth Brahmin, a great guy, an amazing, intelligent person. So one day, king finds all over his country rats are there. So he wanted to kill all the rats, so he catches, gets a lot of cats and give each house one cat. And naturally people ask, we need milk to feed cat. king gives all the each house one own cow so that they can get the milk and give it to cat. So suddenly somebody came and complained to king, people are drinking all their milk by themselves, they are not feeding the cats. So king made a rule, within 1 month he will call for a survey, all people have to bring their cats and it has to be well fed and fat. Everybody got the message, got frightened, and without even consuming single drop of milk, whatever milk they get, they started feeding the cat. Even if the cat doesn't want to drink, they pour in their mouth, and almost all the cats have become fat except Tenali. Tenali fellow still continues to drink all the milk by himself, starving the cat unto death. Finally, on the inspection day, the whole country gathered with their cats, almost like a cat exhibition it was. They are running around all over. And this poor Tenali's cat is almost dead. He brought it by covering it with a cloth under the arms and just threw in front of the king. King was shocked, angry, looked at the Tenali Raman. What is this? What have you done with all the milk? Tenali very innocently says, oh my lord, I don't know, but this cat does not drink milk. King looked in and thought, what? Cat doesn't drink milk? Come on, let's have a medical test. They brought the milk, put it in front of the cat. But really the cat ran away, seeing the milk pot. King was shocked. How can this be? King surrendered to Tenali. I know, you will prove whatever you say. No medical test will work on you. But I just wanted you to reveal the truth to me so that I will sleep peacefully. Otherwise, I will die thinking this. How can a cat run away seeing a milk pot? And Tenali said, I wanted to tell you the foolish act you are doing by feeding so much of milk to these poor cats. If you feed so much milk, how will they kill the rat? Why will they kill the rat and eat if you are giving so much milk? Then king suddenly realized, oh God, that's right. I shouldn't have given the cow. I sent the cat to kill the rats. And if we are giving so much milk to the cat, they all will drink nicely and lie down. Anyhow, Tenali Raman said, all I did is one day made hot milk, really, really boiling milk. I kept and allowed that cat to drink, that's all. Only once that fellow put his mouth, tongue on that milk, that's all. After that, even if he sees any white liquid, that's all. He disappears from the very spot. Understand? Maybe you burnt your tongue like Tenali Raman's cat. You wanted to run away from wealth. You are creating, accumulating poverty. Who knows? So poverty is your joyful, negative abundance.